Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 75th video class of DIP, we will try to understand digital image processing in one shot, or we can say that we will see the summary of whole DIP subject in this video class and its implementation in MATLAB. Although it is very difficult to summarize previous 74 video classes in this single video class, but still we can see different steps of digital image processing that we studied in video lecture number 3, which are also known as different stages or different chapters or topics of digital image processing. And we will also see the implementation of those steps in MATLAB, which we had not implemented at that time, as that was the beginning video lecture of this subject. Okay, so let us start. So while studying video lecture number 3, I told you that this video lecture is a very important video lecture because we study different stages or different chapters or different topics, which are also known as different steps of digital image processing in a single video class. Of course, steps doesn't mean that we have to go one after the another, because object recognition may be the last step, and before that we have already studied representation and description, image compression and color image processing also. So very first question that comes in mind is that why do we study digital image processing? We study digital image processing for our own convenience, to enhance the image or to extract some useful information from the image. We apply image processing on digital images which are discrete or fixed with respect to time. So our problem domain may be to enhance an image or to restore an image or to recognize some object from the image, which we do using digital image processing. And also at that time it was told that it is not necessary that we follow all the steps given here. We may follow 2 or 3 of the steps only as per our required application. So let us start with the first step, that is image acquisition. So what is the meaning of acquisition? Acquisition means to acquire or to obtain the image after sensing. So if this is our object, we sense and acquire the image using the digital camera, and this is our digital image. So remember, image acquisition will always be the very first step in image processing, and the image sensing can be done using a single sensor, a line sensor or an array sensor. And we also studied a simple image formation model in this video class. The next step is image enhancement. To enhance means to improve the quality of the image, and this image enhancement we all are doing nowadays using our smartphones. We manipulate our image so that the result is more suitable than the original for specific applications. So the image enhancement can be done in the spatial domain or the image plane domain itself, or it can also be done in the frequency domain, and we have studied all the techniques in detail. One such image enhancement technique is the histogram equalization, which we have applied over here. So what is histogram equalization? Histogram equalization is a technique used in image processing to enhance the contrast and brightness of an image by equalizing the intensity levels of the image pixels. And the goal of histogram equalization is to make the histogram of the image more uniform, spreading out the intensity values across the entire range of possible values. So after histogram equalization, we obtain an enhanced image like this. Let us implement histogram equalization for this image in MATLAB. So this is our original image, which has more intensity values towards the darker level. And after histogram equalization, we obtain an enhanced image like this, which is very good in quality and also visually very appealing. And the histogram is equalized over the entire range of gray levels. The next step is image restoration. As the name suggests, image restoration means to restore the image or to bring the image to its original condition. The image may be degraded due to noise or various other factors that we have already studied in image degradation and restoration. And our goal is to restore the image to a good quality image. So image restoration is a process of recovering an image that has been degraded, and it uses mathematical or probabilistic models. This is a noisy image which has some random noise superimposed on it, and after applying image restoration we obtain a good noise-free image like this. Let us implement this in MATLAB. The next step of image processing is morphological image processing. Morphological image processing is a branch of image processing that focuses on the analysis and manipulation of image structures based on the shape and form of objects within the image. It is particularly useful for tasks involving object extraction, image enhancement, noise reduction, and feature detection in binary and grayscale images. Morphological image processing is inspired by mathematical morphology, which was originally developed for the analysis of geometric structures in mathematics. In the context of image processing, it operates on binary or grayscale images and employs two fundamental operations, erosion and dilation. And these operations are typically applied using structuring element or kernel or mask, which are small predefined patterns used to analyze and manipulate the images. So if this is the original image, dilation means to add pixels. So here we can see the display board, which after dilation becomes threaded like this. So basically we are adding the pixels and hence diluting the image, right? And as the name suggests, erosion will be removing the pixels or will be eroding the pixels, right? So here we can see in the display board, the letters are eroded, but we can see that this image has become bad image. So one other operation is opening. So opening is similar to erosion, but is less destructive. And similarly, the closing is similar to dilation, but is less destructive, as we can see here. So the closed image is better as compared to the dilated image, and the opened image is better as compared to the eroded image. So opening is generally used to restore or recover the original image to the maximum possible extent, and closing is generally used to smoother the contour of the distorted image and fuse back the narrow breaks and long thin gulfs. Closing is also used for getting rid of the small holes of the obtained image. Let us implement this in MATLAB. The next chapter that we studied in image processing is image segmentation, where the computer tries to separate objects from the image. Image segmentation in digital image processing is the process of partitioning an image into distinct regions or segments based on similarity of pixel properties such as color, intensity or texture. This technique is used to identify and extract meaningful objects or regions within an image, facilitating further analysis and understanding of the content. Common methods of segmentation include thresholding, region growing, edge-based techniques and clustering algorithms. And accurate segmentation is crucial in applications like object recognition, medical image analysis and computer vision. And it is a fundamental step for extracting valuable information from complex images. One such technique of image segmentation is thresholding. Thresholding means the level at which gray level changes starts taking place or division of gray level changes takes place. So if we subdivide the gray level intensities, we can segment the image or we can partition the image. Here using single thresholding, we can partition the image into black and white areas and also partition some objects from the image. So that is global thresholding, we can say, or global segmentation. Similarly, we can do adaptive or local segmentation, where we can partition the image into more than two intensity levels. Let us implement this in MATLAB. Next step is object recognition, which is a very advanced step, and it is a process that assigns a label, for example display board, to an object based on its description. So as the name suggests, object recognition means to recognize an object from the image. For example, we recognize this display board from this image, and it is a very difficult task which involves machine learning and also artificial intelligence. So the place where digital image processing ends, machine learning and artificial intelligence starts from there. Object recognition in digital image processing is the process of identifying and classifying specific objects or patterns within an image. It involves training a model to recognize objects based on their distinctive features such as shape, color or texture, and then applying this model to new images to detect and categorize objects. Common techniques include template matching, feature-based approaches like SIFT, which is scale invariant feature transform, and CNNs, which is convolutional neural networks, and also deep learning methods. Object recognition has a wide range of applications, from facial recognition and autonomous vehicles to industrial automation and augmented reality, where it plays a crucial role in enabling machines to understand and interact with their surroundings. Let us try to recognize this display board from this image in MATLAB. So as I told you, it is a difficult task to recognize object in image processing. What I have done is I have formed a template image, which is just consisting of the display board, and then comparing the template image and the original image, and using comparison, I am detecting the display board. Let us run the program and see the output. So here from this original image, in the template image, I have just kept this display board, and then I am comparing the two images so that this display board is detected. Next step is representation and description. Image representation involves converting an image into suitable format or representation that can be used for further analysis or processing. Image description refers to extracting meaningful information or features from the image for various tasks like object recognition, classification or retrieval. So representation and description actually comes before object recognition. The representation and description in digital image processing focuses on techniques for representing image data into more compact and meaningful way. It involves extracting relevant features such as edges, textures or shapes to create a simplified and informative representation of an image. This process is crucial for reducing the complexity of image data and enabling efficient analysis, comparison and recognition. Common methods include contour tracing, chain codes, boundary descriptors and region-based representations. And effective representation and descriptions are essential for a wide range of applications, from object recognition to image compression and content based image retrieval. So here using edge detection, we convert this image data into suitable form for computer processing. Let us implement this in MATLAB. The next step is image compression. Image compression in digital image processing is the process of reducing the size of an image file while preserving its visual quality. It involves encoding and storing image data in a more efficient format, typically by removing redundant or unnecessary information. Common compression techniques include lossless methods such as run length encoding that maintain image quality and lossy methods such as JPEG that sacrifice some quality for significant file size reduction. Image compression is vital for efficient storage, transmission and sharing of images in various applications from web content to medical imaging and multimedia. It balances the trade-off between the file size and image fidelity. So this is our original image and we will do a compression of not only up to 50% but up to 90% and we will compare both the images. Let us implement in MATLAB. So this is our original image and this is the compressed image, which is 90% compressed as compared to this image, and we just cannot recognize that this image is a compressed image. The quality is so good and we can see in the output that the compression that is achieved is 10.7357 times. That means the image is 90% compressed. And last but not the least is color image processing, which we all like to do nowadays on our smartphones. We apply different filters on our image to make it more enhanced and attractive. Color image processing handles the image processing of colored images either as indexed image or RGB images. So color image processing can be of two types, pseudo color or false color image processing, where we assign false colors to grayscale images for better analysis as shown in this medical image, or full color image processing where we apply different processes on the color image to enhance the color image. So this enhanced color image is obtained by increasing the red color proportion of this original color image. Let us implement this in MATLAB. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. You can download this PPT from the Google Drive link that is given in the description box. Also, all the programs or MATLAB codes are also given in the description box. Thank you very much.